Hello, and welcome once again to Stuff and Things, where I like to discuss stuff, and occasionally even things. I'm your good friend Bradley, and today we have yet another tobacco review, and the tobacco which we will be reviewing is this. It is Dunhill Standard Mixture. Now, is this the standard upon which all English mixtures should be judged? We'll find out. The blend, as I mentioned, is Dunhill Standard Mixture. It is produced by the Scandinavian Tobacco Group, the same group which produces Orlik. They produce all the reissued Dunhill blends. It is available at smokingpipes.com. The 50-gram tin, like this, is $9.30 at smokingpipes.com. At Pipes and Cigars, they have a 50-gram tin for $9.30 as well. And at Four Noggins, the price is normally $9.29. They do that 1 cent undercutting. But they are currently out of stock as of the recording of this video. I'm sure it's something they'll have in on a fairly regular basis. The skin description. Well, the tin description. A balanced blend of Virginia and Turkish tobaccos. Fine, rich flavors. Now, they only mention Virginia and Turkish tobaccos on here. There are obviously also Latakias in here. And the Turkish are... or the Orientals are the Orientals within the blend are Turkish, and the Virginias are East Carolinian and Georgian, and they're all lightly toasted. Something you'll barely notice, mostly through the exhale, is the toasting of the tobacco, but it's definitely there, and it adds just a little more of a subtle overtone to the flavor of the tobacco. The blend type is in English. Of course, it's supposed to be the standard English. The blend contains, as I mentioned, Cyprian Latakia, Orientals, Turkish Orientals, Virginias from East Carolina and Georgia, and they are all lightly toasted. Let me light this up for a second. Before I get into the vital statistics, which I have right here, flavoring. No added flavoring whatsoever. Cut is a ribbon cut. It is that wonderful Dunhill ribbon that I've come to love so much. Now, unfortunately, I have very little left. I've decanted it into my jar, and I enjoyed it so much, I smoked most of it. I just left a little bit so I could do this review, but, aha, I had the foresight to take a video of the cut after I had opened the tin, a couple days after I had first opened the tin. So we will look at that right now. So, here's our tin of Dunhill Standard Mixture. I opened this tin about 2 days ago. I've had a few bowls from it so far. And like most of the Dunhill blends have been recently, it was a little moist out of the tin, so I've left it in here just so it can dry out a little bit. But I thought it would be a good opportunity to show you what it looks like fresh out of the tin to get an idea of the moisture content. You can see still a bit on the moist side, it clumps together a bit, but it's almost there. I'll probably put this in a jar pretty soon, but you can see the standard Dunhill cut. Nice, fine ribbon cut. Very little in the way of twigs or inclusions. And you can see all the different component tobaccos in there. There's the Latakias, the Virginias, Orientals, lightly toasted. Quite lovely. What we've come to expect from Dunhill lately. These Orlik-produced Dunhill blends. There you have it. Now, let us continue with the vital statistics. Strength, medium. Very much a medium strength blend. The taste is also medium. Nicotine level, big surprise, medium. You notice it, especially if you smoke it on an empty stomach, but it's definitely not overpowering in any way. You're not gonna get crazily lightheaded unless you're a real nicotine lightweight. But it's also enough, the level is there to actually realize that you're smoking something. You notice the nicotine. The moisture from the tin, moist towelette. Most of these Dunhill blends, it's funny, when I was first doing reviews, I don't know, in the summer, several months ago, the Dunhill blends all seemed to be just about perfect from the tin, but now they've all been kind of moist lately. And the packaging, as I mentioned, the 50-gram tin. So, if we get to the tin note, or the jar note in this case, let me just take a whiff. It's not overpowering. You definitely can smell the Virginias, and the Latakias are not as to the forefront as they are in some of the other Dunhill English blends, even less so than probably 965. way less so than in nightcap. But you can smell them there. And interestingly, when I get to the main body of the review and I'll talk about the taste a little more, you can smell a sweetness, more of a sweetness, probably from the Virginias and a little bit from the Orientals, than you do when you actually smoke it. You don't taste the sweetness as much as you can smell it in the tin note. And there's just a little bit of the tang and spiciness from the Orientals. Definitely not as Oriental forward as, say, Durbar, if we're going to compare it to another Dunhill blend. The room note on this one, it's kind of middle of the road. It's not as strong and doesn't have as much of that incense character that some Latakia blends have. And it's probably not as cigarette-y as, say, my mixture. Kind of middle of the road. I don't consider it offensive at all, since, of course, I like the smell of this tobacco burning. And I have not had any non-smokers around to tell me their opinion of it, but I would assume that it's not going to be too offensive, and it doesn't seem to linger very much at all. Now, if we get to the actual review, I smoked probably a little more than half of this while I was writing up my review notes, so let me relight this baby. Right off the bat, to deal with the mechanics, packs well, lights well, stays lit well, smokes cool. I haven't been able to get this to bite at all either. So in that regard, very nice. Now, when I first lit this up, my first bowl of this, I wrote down in my notes, it had kind of a... Now, this will sound bad, but I don't mean this to sound bad. It had a sort of slightly acrid, bitter flavor to it, and the closest thing I could put my finger on to what it tasted like was kind of a creosote sort of taste. You know, if you see old docks in a lake or something, they'll have these giant posts that have been soaked in creosote, and it was a way of waterproofing them. And that sounds horrible and chemically and everything, but it doesn't taste bad at all. But it has that sort of... slightly acrid, slightly bitter, almost slightly metallic taste to it. Like if you've ever licked a big hunk of metal before. I don't know why you would, but maybe you have. And I still taste that now, but it's not as apparent as it was the first couple bowls that I smoked. And there's almost a flavor of like... I think I wrote down in my notes, yes, like smoking crushed walnut shells. Again, these things, it's interesting when you're talking about tobacco smoke, because there's some flavors you use or some descriptive words you use to describe the character of the smoke that don't necessarily sound appetizing. And I think that's because when we think of appetizing, we think of food, we think of things that you could use to describe the flavors of different foods that you might eat. Smoke, you're not eating it, you're imbibing it, I suppose. I don't inhale it, I guess some people do, but you're tasting it within your mouth, and there are certain flavors that I can only describe as not food-like, but that does not mean that they are not pleasant. So this creosote-y crushed walnut shell kind of flavor that I'm noticing here, this metallic taste, this kind of bitter aftertaste, I actually really enjoy it, and that's one of the main parts of this blend that kind of set it apart for me and something that make it something that I've really enjoyed. It has kind of a dry, earthy character, soil-like, kind of loamy soil, not very sweet. The Virginias are in there and you can taste them and you taste a little bit of the sweetness from them, but it's not at all overpowering. It's very balanced in that way. And as I mentioned before, when you smell the blend just, you know, in the tin, you can smell more of the sweetness than you can taste when you're actually smoking it. And the toasting is noticeable, but more as you're releasing it from your mouth. It's more of a mouth feel and kind of maybe in the nostrils if you exhale through your nose. And I guess they do say lightly toasted, so it's not very, very strong in the toasting aspect, but you can tell it's there. Now, if we're going to compare this to other Dunhill blends, which of course makes sense, a blend like Durbar, which is more Oriental forward, has that real tangy, almost sour, kind of a cross between sweet and sour. It's weird. And it's something, or kind of olivey taste, I think I've described it before. And the Turkish Orientals in this, they don't really impart much of that to this blend. They're definitely more in the background, I think, even more so than the Virginias. The Latakia, it's interesting because I would say that no particular aspect of this blend overshadows any of the other components, but I can't say that, the Virginia and the Turkish Orientals seem to be in the background, which would suggest that the Latakia is in the forefront, but then at the same time, I wouldn't say that this is a predominantly Latakia-flavored blend. It's very interesting. It's this amazing interplay of balance and flavors where no one predominates. I don't know, it's quite interesting. But also not complicated. It's not tremendously nuanced at all. It's just kind of good, honest English blend. I guess you could say maybe it is the standard English blend, because there's nothing that jumps out at you and says, oh, look at me, taste me. But it's really good. I really enjoy it. Yeah, this isn't a kitchen sink blend at all. It's just really nice, stolid, good English mixture. As I'm steadily working my way through reviewing all of the recently reissued Dunhill blends produced by the Scandinavian Tobacco Group, I'm struck by how they all so far have seemed pretty much essential. I haven't seen any that seem to be extraneous or not needed. They all offer their own sort of specific flavor profile to the entire patchwork quilt that makes up the Dunhill brand of tobaccos. And this really slots in there. Maybe between, if you're into Nightcap and 965, but Nightcap can get a little bit overpowering in the Latakia department, and 965 can sometimes be a little sweet maybe, or maybe just a little too complicated. The standard mixture is just a very good, tasty, uncomplicated, honest English blend. And that bitter kind of acrid finish that I enjoy, it really adds something to this. It's kept me coming back. I bought this tin for review and I almost smoked the entire thing without reviewing it. So I had to really be disciplined and say, no, you have to leave at least a bowl to do your review. So, Dunhill Standard Mixture. An excellent, honest, uncomplicated English blend. Is it the baseline standard by which all other English mixtures should be judged? Why not? I quite enjoyed it. I think you will too. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, I've been your good friend Bradley. You have been the audience. This has been Stuff and Things. Good day.